Now coming to the following ayah number 30. وَإِذْ قَالَ رَبُّكَ لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةً قَالُوا أَتَجْعَلُ فِيهَا مَن يُفْسِدُ فِيهَا وَيَسْفِكُ الدِّمَاءَ وَنَحْنُ نُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِكَ وَنُقَدِّسُ لَكَ قَالَ إِنِّي أَعْلَمُ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ Ayah number 30 of Surah Al-Baqarah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, And remember when your Lord said to the angels, Verily, I'm going to place mankind generations after generations, or creating mankind, creating Khalifa in this earth. قَالُوا أَتَجْعَلُ فِيهَا مَنْ يُفْسِدُ فِيهَا Okay. They said, will you place therein those who will make mischief therein and shed blood? وَنَحْنُ نُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِكَ وَنُقَدِّسُ لَكَ And we glorify you with praises and thanks and sanctify you. قَالَ إِنِّي أَعْلَمُ مَا لَتَعْلَمُونَ Allah said, I know that which you do not know. So this is the story of the creation of the Adam alayhi salam, the first man. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةً I'm going to create in the earth Khalifa. What does it mean, the Khalifa? Meaning of Khalifa. First up, before Khalifa, وَإِذْ قَالَ رَبُّكَ Your Lord said, لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ for the angels. Imam Qurtubi mentioned meaning of Rabb. رَبُّكَ your Lord. Your Rabb has meaning of Al-Malik, Al-Sayyid, Al-Muslih, Al-Jabir. Meaning of Rabb is Malik, the master, the owner. As-Sayyid, the leader, the commander who guides us, who commands us, who leads us. Wal-Muslih, the one who do correction. If anything wrong with us, he will be correcting us. He's a Muslih, he's also Rabb. Wal-Jabir, again repairing. If anything goes wrong, he is the one who And do the repairment. This is the meaning Imam Qurtubi mentioned about Ar-Rabb. Now, lil malaika, he's saying to the malaika, to the angels. Okay, Allah is going to create Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, the Khalifa. Why does he need to speak to the angels? Does he need their advice, suggestion? خاطب الله الملائكة لا للمشورة. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did talk to the angels about creation of Adam, not having consultation with them. If they agree, he will be creating. If they don't agree, he will be not creating. This is not the case. لا للمشاورة ولكن لاستخراج ما فيهم من رؤية الحركات والعبادة والتسبيح والتقديس. Rather, to know how much they accept Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's command and wholeheartedly how they welcome and how they glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and know his more kudrah that what he's going to create and what it will know, you know, all the ayat after will be coming. They were shocked. They did not know many things. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to show them his kudrah more. And that's why, you know, ayah will be coming later on. Could you inform me the names of the all creation? They said, oh Allah, we don't know except what you taught us. They said, I have many things you don't know. I'm creating someone, he will tell all of these names. So it is to show them that how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mulk and his ability, his qudrah, That is, and they will be saying in the end, glorifying more Allah, Subhanak. That is the main purpose. It is not to take their mushwara. And also, why they said, are you going to create those who, some kind of objection you may find there, that is coming later on. Imam Qurtubi took a lot of time to discuss word Khalifa. إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةً This word, taking many pages of Tafsir Qurtubi, And he also said in Jain, fil ardi, in the earth, in the earth. Which earth is referred here? This dunya, but which place of dunya? He said maybe it is Makkah. Why Makkah? Because Makkah is a center point of this whole planet. And he said, "Duhiyat al-ardu." There is a hadith narrated, "Duhiyat al-ardu min Makkah." In a moment, from the water, Allah Subhanahu wa Taala created the earth first. Earth was not coming all together in one go. It took time. It came gradually. And some of the continents' existence came later on. Many of the islands are coming, new islands are discovered. Is it not true? The whole world didn't come all together. There's how many continents? 7 continents? They didn't come all together from the earth. It came gradually. And why the starting of the first appearance of the earth from underneath the water is Makkah. That's a hadith referred, duhiyat al-ardu min Makkah. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the ayah before we learn, وَالْأَرْضَ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ دَحَاهَا. This, and he spread the earth after that. Spreading the earth continued. Even Antarctica came in people's knowledge after, you know, many centuries, just a couple of centuries ago, I think last century or century before, only Antarctica came in existence and in people's knowledge. So that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the name of Makkah, Ummul Qura. In the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that I have sent you with this wahi, لَتُنْذِرَ أُمَّ الْقُرَىٰ وَمَنْ حَوْلَهَا. That you warn people of Ummul Qura, the mother of the all villages, mother of the all inhabitants, mother of the all localities, which is center point, وَمَنْ حَوْلَهَا, and who are around them. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was in Ummul Qura, in Makkah, and he was warning them, people of Jazeera al-Arabiya around Makkah. So Ummul Qura, mother, means origin. Origin. It's the original village, original human inhabitants were there. That's what many of the riwayas suggest, which is not very authentically verified, but that Adam alayhi salam and, you know, around this area, that's Arafat, he met Hawa alayhi salam there. There are some suggestion came, and also there is a grave of Hawa, something was called near Jeddah, although it is a historic information, not very authentically proven. So it is. It seems Adam alayhi salam were around that area, Ummul Qura, and it is even today. It is proven that center of the whole world is Makkah, scientifically proven. If you go somewhere searching the information about Ummul Qura, you'll find this information in the internet maybe. Some of the research gone. Makkah is center point of the whole planet, in exactly in the middle. Ummul Qura is very appropriate name. Okay? That's why Makkah has another name, Ummul Qura. And that's why there's a university there called Jamiat Ummul Qura, Ummul Qura University. And Imam Qurtubi said, قَالَ نُوحْ عَهُودَ صَالِحَ شُعِبْ بَيْنَ زَمْزَمْ وَالرُّقْنَ وَالْمَقَامِ. There are some kind of narration came that the grave of Nuh alayhi salam and Hud alayhi salam and Salih alayhi salam and Shu'aib alayhi salam, it is in Makkah, even in near the Masjid al-Haram, between Zamzam and Maqam Ibrahim. These riwayat are not very strong. Allahu alam, it may be some Israeli sources only. And it is also very doubtful, question mark here, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be allowing the people to be praying on the grave. It is against the Sharia. That's why these information. Imam Qurtubi sometimes he mentions some of the information from the Ahl al-Kitab source, which is not very authentically verified. Then he said another important point: ويجوز أن يكون خليفة بمعنى مفعول أي مخلف أو مخلف. So it could be that Khalifa means the one who comes after somebody. Why Abu Bakr is Khalifa to Rasulullah? He came next after Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Khalifa to Rasulullah, who come after. Imam Ibn Kathir rahmatullah alayhi mentioned Khalifa means those who are coming generation after generation. That's why even Adam alayhi wasallam came after after jinns who are inhabitants of this planet. They were living before Adam alayhi wasallam is here in this planet. They were the inhabitant of the planet. But they did so much corruption, which is these ayats is telling the Sahaba's experience of seeing the creation. مَنْ يُفْسِدُ فِيهَا وَيَسْفِكُ الدِّمَاء. So Adam alayhi wasallam and human being came after jinns. It is one of the meaning of Khalifa, who comes after. Although Khalifa has a terminology give another meaning, who is in charge, like viceroy, who is representative of Allah in this planet. He established Sharia of Allah. So two meaning of Khalifa. You understand these two meaning? One is who come after, generation after generation is also mentioned in the Quran. ثُمَّ جَعَلْنَاكُمْ خَلَائِفَ فِي الْأَرْضِ مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ لِنَنْظُرَ كَيْفَ تَعْمَلُونَ. In Surah Yunus ayah number 14, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, then we made you successors after them. It could be insan after jinn. It could be this ummah after the previous ummah's nations. Generations after generations in the land that we might see you how you work. So this is one meaning of Khalifa, generation after generation, or insan after jinn. Or the other meaning is Khalifa fil ard, to implement ahkam of Sharia, ahkam of Allah in this planet, as he is representative of Allah to implement the Sharia. These two meaning came. And of course, sending Adam alayhi salam to implement Sharia of Allah as a prophet. And that meaning is taken seriously by Imam Qurtubi, that insan is viceroy of Allah, representative of Allah. وَالْمَعْنَى بِالْخَلِيفَةِ هُنَا, as Ibn Mas'ud, Ibn Abbas, many of the Mufassirun said, it is Adam alayhi salam. وَهُوَ خَلِيفَةُ اللَّهِ, he is Allah's Khalifa. Allah's Khalifa in what? فِي إِمْضَاءِ أَحْكَامِهِ وَأَوَامِرِهِ, by implementing Allah's command and his directions. لأنه أول رسول إلى الأرض, he was the first messenger to this earth. Okay, as hadith of Abu Dharr رضي الله عنه said, يا رسول الله أنبيا كان مرسلا, if Adam was a prophet, a messenger, he said قال نعم, yes, of course. Then وَيُقَالُ لِمَنْ كَانَ رَسُولًا وَلَمْ يَكُنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ أَحَدٍ, if somebody says, whom he sent as a messenger, there's no people before him. He is Nabi Haris, his ummah. Okay. فَيُقَالُ كَانَ رَسُولًا إِلَى وَلَدِهِ, answer is, he was messenger to his children, who is becoming later on very soon. And he got, mashallah, good number of children. وَكَانُوا أَرْبَعِينَ وَلَدًا, he had 40 children, some of the riwaya suggests, not very so authentic, maybe some from Ahl al-Kitab source. And how they were born, فِي عِشْرِينَ بَطْنًا, in the 20 delivery of his wife. She was giving every child, couple, twin, boy, girl, ذكر وأنثى. And this is the story of Habil and Qabil, as you know, how one killed other one, and this Sunnah or the Sharia was there. This couple this twin will marry the next twin's one. One of this twin will marry next twin's another one. Not the same, but marry haram to each other. But halal, all the brother sister was from the next twin. That was the Sharia at that time. So he allowed sister to get married with the brother. That is because there is no other solution for them. For that Sharia of Adam alayhi salam was halal. But later on, when they increased following generation, following prophet, made it haram. Hatta kathuru. And within his lifetime, mashallah, big number of children of Adam was spreading, children and grandchildren and grandchildren. He has seen many of them. As Allah said, خَلَقَكُم مِّن نَفْسٍ وَاحِدًا. You know, He has created you from one soul. Who is that? Adam. وَخَلَقَ مِنْهَا زَوْجَهَا. And created from him his wife. وَبَثَّ مِنْهُمَا رِجَالًا كَثِيرًا وَنِسَاءً. And then spread from both of them many men and women. So he got, mashallah, many children and grandchildren, all. Okay. وعاش 930 سنة. And he was having a life span of 930 years. هكذا ذكر أهل التوراة. This information from the Torah source, from Bani Israel source. Do you believe it or not?
Have some books, he said 900,
he was to... Yeah, so about that Israeli sources, what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَا تُكَذِّبُوا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابَ وَلَا تُصَدِّقُهُمْ. Don't need to firmly believing that, neither reject everything. But anything is not contradictory to the Quran and Sunnah, could be considered maybe there is a chance of truth there, but not very certain. However, if Nuh alayhi salam was getting life of 950 years, which is in the Quran, so it is not very unlikely to have Adam's alayhi salatu wasalam some kind of longer lifespan. Another riwayah suggests from Wahab ibn Munabbih, who was a tabi'i, and he was very expert in Ahlul Kitab's knowledge. He was a Jew before. He said, Annahu Asha Alfa Sana. The other one's lifespan was 1,000 years. Okay, now Khalifa, again, Imam Qurtubi find, إِنِّي جَعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةً. From there he's making many masail of Khilafah. Okay, he said, هَذِي الْآيَ أَصْلٌ فِي نَصْبِ إِمَامٍ وَخَلِيفَةٍ يِسْمَهُ لَهُ وَيُطَاعٌ. This ayah is main dalil of having Ummah, their leader, their Khalifa should be, Ummah should not be living without leader. Okay. لتجتمع به الكلمة وتنفذ به أحكام الخليفة. So Ummah's word will be united and their Sharia will be implemented by the authority of the Islamic ruler, which is titled is خليفة. ولا خلاف في وجوب ذلك بين الأمة ولا بين الأئمة. And there is no اختلاف between Ummah about this issue, that particularly to have their leader. Ummah should not be living, leaderless. There should be a leader in their society, in their community, in their country, in their, area. Okay. But Khalifa, this title was used for Adam alayhi salam. It could be used by the Muslims, Khalifa to Rasulullah. But they also use another terminology. Not necessarily always Khalifa, Khalifa. Could be another terminology. It was used as Amirul Mu'mineen. Many of the Sahaba addressed Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, Umar radiallahu anhu as Amirul Mu'mineen, meaning leader of the believers. So that means it's not necessarily always you chant with the word of Khalifa. It could be another terminology used. But the concept is Ummah should have the leader. Okay, if there is no leader in Muslim community, what will happen? There will be no law and order. That's why it is very important, even if you are three, you should have an Amir. And that this Ummah is a Jama'ah. Okay, even you are in Safar, three people, one of you should become Amir. So this is a good sunnah. But if it is a big territory without any leader to discipline them, to keep law and order, then there will be no security of anyone. Okay? And if it is not ideal leadership is available for the ummah, even some kind of, any kind of leader should be there. If Islamic leadership is not available for the security and safety of the people, there should be some kind of leadership there, law and order is there for the people's security. That if you look into As-Siyasat al-Shar'iyyah of Imam Ibn Taymiyyah rahmatullah alayhi, it is wajib upon the ummah to have their leader. And if not, it will be chaos and it will be, nobody's life will be insecure. Okay. Now he's mentioning another point. وَأَجْمَعَتِ الصَّحَابَةُ عَلَى تَقْدِيمِ الصِّدِّيقِ بَعْدَ اخْتِلَافٍ وَقَعَ بَيْنَ الْمُهَاجِرِينَ وَالْأَنصَارِ فِي السَّقِيفَةِ بَنِي سَعِيدَ فِي التَّعْيِينِ. He's saying the Sahaba are having a problem when Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم passed away. Sahaba are having a debate, discussion, who will be their leader. And they gathered in a place called Saqifatu Bani Sa'ida. A Sahabi's, Ansari Sahabi's, Madinan Ansari Sahabi's meeting place called Saqifatu Bani Sa'ida. There was a nice farmland of Bani Sa'ida tribe. And they have a little bit of roof type of like assembly hall, open hall type. They gathered together, mostly Ansar of Medina, before Muhajirun. You know the two communities in Medina, Muhajir and Ansar. The Ansar gathered there, they thought, and the people of Mecca, although they have so much contribution, but since this is our land, they thought naturally, one of us should be the Amir. That's how they discuss within them who will be the Amir of Medina now. When this news came to Umar radiallahu anhu and Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, they went to see them. They said, well, as you know, Umar radiallahu anhu was speaking, probably a good idea will be that we consider all together Muhajirun and Ansar. And as you know, the how Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself was a Muhajir from Mecca to Medina, and the great Sahaba amongst the Muhajirun, we can't exclude them, of course, in time of making decision. Then they said, well, that's good then, fine. Then Ishwa, why not have the two leaders, Minna Amir wa Minkum Amir? One from Ansar and one from Muhajirun. It's a dual leadership. And they will consult and they do. But two Amir's concept is very
difficult.
It doesn't work. Okay. Because Abu Bakr Umar radiallahu anhu says, as you know, it is not only city of Medina, it is much more. Mecca is conquered at that time already under the Islamic State. And even local other tribes and regional area, all of them came under the leadership of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The people of Arabia will not listen except the leader of the Quraysh. And that's why Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam hinted that Al-Amiru min Quraysh. The leader should be coming from the Quraysh. The Arab people of Arabia will not take from any tribe leadership. Because the Quraysh are very well respected tribe in the whole Arabia. To keep the unity of the Ummah, only a Quraysh leader is the right one, and many of the ahadith in that they mentioned. Okay, إن العرب لا تدين إلا لهذا الحي من قريش فرجعوا وطاعوا لقريش. Then of course they, Alhamdulillah, Sahaba came to their senses. Ansar Sahabi agreed, and Umar radiallahu anhu himself came forward to say, if you remember, although Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم did not impose upon us his successor, he didn't say clearly. He say about the Quraysh, but he did not mention the name of the person who should be after him, our leader. But he has indirectly give any clue to you if you are thinking that. What the clues were? When Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi fallen ill in his deathbed, whom he is given responsibility of salah? Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. And many of the ahadith about virtue of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, his position, Umar radiallahu anhu said, and he said, "Oh my brothers of Ansar, I am convinced if you consider, if you agree the leadership from the Quraysh, that is finally accepted, and if you are convinced that Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu about him, all these messages given by Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you know, his status, I am very convinced he is best in whole ummah, our community, so I accept him as my leader." And he did bayah. Alhamdulillah, within a short period of time, all Sahaba Ansar came forward and they did bayah. Alhamdulillah, so there is no chaos, no dispute remain. It was just, you know, in the beginning, because Rasulullah did not mention the name. He given right to the Ummah to choose themselves by discussion. That, mashallah, very nicely came and settled easily. And Umar radiallahu anhu played a very decisive role here of making Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu the leader. And then, of course, his Imam Qurtubi rahmatullah alayhi said that Imamiyya Shia people, they disagree. They said, no, Ummah has no right to choose their leader. The leader should be decided by the Nas, by the text of the Quran and Sunnah, by the Prophet's words here. Prophet should be giving the word, who will be his leader, and he left the word in favor of Ali radiallahu anhu. They have their so-called ahadith. Prophet said, after me, leader will be Ali. And they said, Abu Bakr, Umar, and all Sahabi who agreed with making bayah in the hand of Abu Bakr, they all disobeyed the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. They participated in the conspiracy of depriving Ali from the leadership. Can you accept that? No. You can't accept that. How come that all of the great Sahaba, Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Ali, all this will be going against the word, his text of the Prophet, and they would agree something against the Prophet's text? Impossible. But that's why Shia people, they curse even Abu Bakr and Umar radiallahu anhu.
Sheikh, you say Abu Bakr and Umar is in a meeting in, with Ansar. He's not there in that time.
You see? So this is, he dealt with them. He's still Shia, many of them. They consider the Sahaba did breach to the text of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and it was a conspiracy to deprive Ali radiallahu anhu. They still believe that. The best group of Shia are called Zaydiya. They are mostly inhabitant of Yemen. Nowadays there is also a bit of further deviation with them, but before, they were considered as best. They said, well, يَجُوزُ إِمَامَةُ الْمَفْدُولِ عَلَى الْإِمَامِ الْفَاضِلِ عَلَى وُجُودِ الْفَاضِلِ. They said, most of the Shia said, Abu Bakr's leadership, this process of election, electing him, bayah on him, was batil, was kabira sin, was haram, was against a Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was sinful. And that's why they curse many of them who did agree. But Zaydiya Shia people said, no, although Ali was better, but if Ummah, by discussion, they choose somebody less caliber than Ali, less qualified than Ali, less status than Ali, if they agree, it is allowed. Like today, somehow Muslims are electing their Amir. If they did not choose, the number one should be they didn't choose the number one, they choose the number two or number three best among them, then it is okay, because it is the option of the Ummah. It is still valid. But they still, Zaidiya people still consider Ali was the better one. But the good thing with them, they never say it is illegal. Abu Bakr's leadership election was not illegal to their understanding. Although Sahaba missed the best option. This is the best of their opinion. And those who are not Zaidiya, they say not only they missed the best option, they committed a crime, they should be cursed. That's why in Iraq today, to have the name of Abu Bakr and Umar is no security for them, will be chopped by Shia. Many of them are killed, only their name is Abu Bakr and Umar. So this point we'll finish here. In Ijail fil Ard Khalifa, and he mentioned many other points of the Khalifa. I don't think we are electing a Khalifa now. So inshallah, whenever time will come, we'll be looking for the further things. We'll be going to the next point in the next week, that is قَالُوا أَتَدْعَلُ فِيهَا مَنْ يُفْسِدُ فِيهَا. As the angels raise something to Allah, oh Allah, are you going to create somebody who will be doing mischief and will be making bloodshed? Why is it considered an objection from them? Do they have any right of objection or not? That will be discussed inshallah next week. بإذن الله. We'll stop here. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.